Okay? And we worship only that God. We don't worship anybody else. So we emphasize on the oneness from the very get-go, from the very start. Do you understand?
Yeah, well,
and since you already believe that, so you shouldn't have... I don't think that is a main point of contention with you, isn't it?
Yeah, I truly feel that, truly believe is one.
Yeah. What about the messenger, the prophet of Hud of Prophet Muhammad? Do you believe that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah?
It's a bit tough.
Yeah, sure. You want to come this side?
Can I put my bag down?
Yeah, sure you can. Just put it here. It'll be safe. Ali, hurry up, man. So this brother here, he's just accepted Islam, and he made the declaration of faith that there's only one God and Allah is the one who is worthy of worship. And he also declared, because he has been watching our videos for quite a while, and he's come to the conclusion based on his own research, without anyone forcing him or any sort of pressure on him. And because your parents are already Muslim, I'm just a bit curious to know that what is it about Islam that you find objection to from what you know about Islam?
It's use of it.
Say again?
It's use of it.
Yeah, yeah. Do you want to sit down? It's up to you.
Oh, no, I'll stand. I'll stand.
You understand? Okay, he wants to stand. Yeah. So what do you think is... Because you wouldn't... Would you call yourself a Muslim?
Not in this traditional sense, I don't think so.
Okay. So what is... Why is that? Why would you not... Even though your parents are Muslim, why would you not consider... He doesn't want to sit, he wants to stand. He wants to stand, yeah.
Can I stand? Is that right?
Yeah.
Ustad, come to here.
Yeah, inshallah.
Come here.
Alright, come here.
Since he's just reverted, is he also allowed to come into the conversation to also give his view?
Yeah, sure. Michael.
I'm wanted.
So he wants your view as to why you reverted to Islam. So his parents are Muslims, but he has some contentions about Islam. I'm trying to find out what and why he has some objections.
Big responsibility.
I know, but I think
you can just say your truth.
I think he feels comfortable maybe if you give your view as to why you became a Muslim just now. And maybe he'll give his view as to why he doesn't consider himself a Muslim in the traditional sense. So maybe, do you want to tell us your view as to why you don't consider yourself a Muslim?
Yeah, I mean, for example, you just became Muslim today, right?
Yeah, a few minutes ago.
All right.
Literally. Yes. Yeah.
I'm jumping to move over.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, yeah. I was just wondering, like, why, in that case, and why should I, for example?
I mean, I'm not going to stand here and profess to ask you how you want.
I thought probably, I believe in what you believe, maybe, right? Like, God is one, oneness of God. I feel like, you know, when I listen to Malcolm X, I feel like the end of his life, the oneness of humanity, I think that everyone should be Muslim. Why? You know what I mean? I think that makes sense. Like, you and I came from the same two pairs, right? One pair from them came us.
But you already believe in the oneness of God, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And you also...
I heard everything you just said.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, like what Ali just said to me, it sounds like you're Muslim already.
What made you... Okay, what's the difference between your leap and my leap? Like, what made you make a leap if there isn't a leap?
I wouldn't call it a leap unless, I mean, you'll hear other people probably say it's a leap of faith, but for me it's not, it's a knowing. Like I was literally just speaking like a few minutes ago about... You got a lot on your shoulders. Like, what would I mean? Unlike you, I would have. What's my mum gonna think? I mean, my mum got me baptized Christian Orthodox.
Yeah.
My first two children are baptized Greek Orthodox. But it's a cultural thing, and it was done to please my family because I want them to be happy for me and my celebration of my children. But like I was saying to Ali, I've never believed in. the 3-in-1. That doesn't make sense to me. It just confuses. Plus, there's the education part. I mean, I'm only talking about Christianity. That, you know, what is it, 400 years after the passing of Jesus, they meet a load of times and they talk about these, I believe, 27 books put into one to make the Bible. But where's the other books? You know what? You're hearing that it's like the Gospel of, Gospel of Barnaby or something, has just come out completely denying that Jesus was God and he wasn't crucified, but Judah was. So for me, this is like affirmation for me. It's like, yeah, I knew there was something weird about it. I don't agree with people. For me, it's the Roman Empire is just taking over a different form. The whole thing was falling apart. They wanted to bring the people back together. That's why there are pagan traditions within the Christian state. Like, we know for a fact Jesus was never born in 25th. We know that, but we still live the lie that he was.
No, in the Old Testament it says, do not go and chop up trees and bring them to houses and decorate them.
Again, that's a pagan thing with the blood.
But his background is Muslim, not Christian?
No, I'm not talking, I'm saying in general.
Yeah, like, so he's given his point of view because he comes from a Christian background, and he wasn't satisfied with the narrative of what the Christians are preaching about Christianity, 3-in-1, crucifixion and so on, all these things, you know. So if I were to ask you that, if you believe in one God, you're already like there, but then you need to have you studied the biography of Muhammad, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam?
So what's the thing with the brother? I'm trying to
say. His parents are Muslims, but he's saying he doesn't consider himself a Muslim in the traditional sense. I don't know what that means. I'm trying to figure that out.
Do you have like, what's the scriptures? You know, you said you're talking a leap of faith.
Yeah.
So he just came in. I said he just became Muslim.
He just became Muslim.
Okay, I just wanted to know why. Is it that means you're different now than when a couple of minutes ago you weren't Muslim?
Yeah.
What's the difference now? What happens?
I see.
It's like nikah. You know, when you get married, you was haram. A few statements were made and you became halal. The meat that you slaughter, if you don't slaughter in the name of God, it becomes haram. If you slaughter in the name, so even though it's something we can't physically see, it's something that we have belief in. So for example, sometimes my family comes and says to me, why don't you do a actual marriage ceremony? You know, like the legal. And I say, so is that more important than me doing it? To me, it's more important than the sight of God. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So the thing is, we have, Islam is a whole lifestyle.
So it's another testimony.
Yeah, it is.
He's doing now, he's just utters a few words. Someone might say, oh wow, now you're a new person.
It's a declaration of faith. So say for example, you know, like if you go and work for a company, they make you sign a contract.
Yes.
So before you signed the contract, you were not officially an employee. But as soon as you signed it, you become an employee.
Yes, exactly.
So it's a declaration either in writing. In this case, it was a declaration by verbally, which is not really, you know, even if a person in his heart, if he accepts Islam, like he says, I believe in only one God and I believe Muhammad is the messenger. He did not declare anything, but he actually testified in his heart. Yes, Allah accepts that as well. But this is because once you are a Muslim, people like the nikah, you want to make it public. You want people to know that now you have left your previous life and you have now adopted the life or the deen, the one of Islam. And now everything that Islam says is forbidden for me, and everything that is halal, that is permitted, is now permitted for me. So this is it, like for him, he's got more to lose. He's right, absolutely. His parents, his family, his friends, you know, many people, they lose all of that. In your case, I think the transition will be easier because your family and your mom and your dad, they're already Muslims, alhamdulillah.
It's more like, I feel a lot of people are true in saying that. It's a lot of external, and what is Muslim on the outside is different from the inside. Like,
well, of course, for example,
it has to be both,
you know what I mean?
You have the monarchical, like, what one thing?
No, I don't mean, okay, go ahead, yeah. Sorry, go ahead, yeah.
Monarchical, like, for example, one thing I would say, just believing in the heart, because the uncle of the Abu Talib, the prophet, he knew Islam was a truth, but he didn't utter it. So he died as a disbeliever. So if you believe in your heart and you don't utter it, for example, it's not enough. There are people who don't, they utter it on their tongue, but they don't believe in the heart. We call them munafiqs. They pretend to be Muslims. What's like, why do you not identify yourself as a Muslim? What's the
problem? What do you call the Prophet's uncle then, who died in the
So he died in disbelief because
so is he not munafiq?
Not munafiq because he believed it, but there's two things. You believe in your heart, you don't believe in your tongue. You're a disbeliever.
Michael, you want to come
on
here?
Your tongue,
sorry.
It's just I've got the microphone. It's easier to pick up the sound.
See, if I say to you, you know what? Okay, let me repeat again. The prophet's uncle, he believed in his heart, but he didn't say it on his tongue. He was a guided disbeliever.
So a few minutes ago, this man was exactly the same as
the uncle,
for example? He believed it without declaring it?
Yes, but the thing is, the reason he rejected it was because of what people, his tribesmen would think.
The thing is, he already believed in his heart before he made the declaration.
And nothing stopped him.
The reason he came here...
Is that true? Yeah.
Because he could have said...
Otherwise, he wouldn't have come here to say...
How come he had to come here? How come he felt to come here?
This is destiny.
I literally made it. Last week was the first time I came to Hyde Park Corner. I've lived in London all my life, virtually, and I've never been here before. And this last week was the first one. And I was looking for Ali, Mohammed, gentleman next to me here,
Hashim,
the great honourable
Hamza,
gentleman.
You know, all these guys are always on these videos for us to doubt. Because I suppose deep down I knew I was coming to the park to submit. So I mean, it's been something that's been going on for about 3 years, and all I can say is I've been putting the barriers in the way.
How do you feel now after accepting Islam? Is it like something give you peace in your heart and that you declare?
That's subjective, really. That's subjective.
Because I need some time to ponder on it. Yeah. I mean, everything that's happened in my life is big, like, you know, children, marriage. It takes a little time to settle in.
You have your eureka moment. No, some people
settles
think,
in, yeah, and then you start taking.
Yeah, some people think you take shahada and the white light comes in.
I mean, the fact that he has approached the table to take the shahada, he is already made up. So his eureka moment was before that, I think.
Yeah.
This was just a formality.
So
is that right, Michael? Yeah.
Where are you?
May I ask about his barriers then?
But by the way, Brother Hassan, you know, everybody has their own, what do you say, their own destiny, their own path that they take. So sometimes what we do is we think that if I compare my life and my path and my destiny with somebody else, maybe there's a match, yes? But everybody comes with their own, what do you say, their own path, their own pathway, their own destiny. So I think it's best if you tell us what is stopping you from saying that I'm a Muslim in the traditional sense. What is it that's hindering your declaration of taking the shahada?
I don't feel the Muslims themselves understand.
No, forget about everybody else. I'm talking about just yourself.
But you're a Muslim. Do you believe in Allah?
Maybe I believe in what you believe.
Exactly, yeah.
What was it? Do you believe in Allah?
I believe in God.
But do you believe Allah, like, specifically?
But if I say yeah, I could be the same as the other Arabs who used to believe in pagan days.
But that's what I'm saying. The concept of Allah. So, for example...
Yeah, the concept of Allah is just an Arabic word for God, right? The God.
Not really.
Al-Ilah, right?
But it's his name as well.
Yeah, yeah, the name is just an Arabic name. You could... Before Arabia...
No, but you know what he means. He means,
okay,
look...
Do you believe in Allah's lordship?
Yeah.
God's lordship.
Yeah, he's the one who controls the heavens and the earth.
Yeah, I believe in the oneness of that.
Do you believe in his Uluhiyya? Do you believe that you should worship him alone?
Serve him alone, right?
Yeah, like worship him alone. Like, you don't go through anybody. Jesus, statue.
Only he is worthy of worship. Nobody else.
Okay, do you believe in Allah's names and attributes? He's the most powerful, the most merciful. Do you believe in those names?
Yeah, I believe most people do.
Okay, that's Allah. If you say I believe in Allah...
What's the difference then? What's the barriers you had before?
No, we're talking about your barriers, my friend. He's already accepted it.
I know, but he's allowing me to ask this question. And
if you feel like it's an important chapter of your journey, then I don't mind answering.
All right, yeah, I do actually, yeah. What was your barrier?
Like I was saying before, my family, my culture, the way I've been raised. But over the years, I've made a lot of choices to change my life. And it's been going on for at least 3. I've gone completely vegan. I don't eat any meat anymore because I just don't like the whole process in this country about how we deal with meat. I don't drink alcohol anymore. I made that declaration. I don't gamble. These are all things that I've been doing pretty much my whole life, even down to something like something silly like the national lottery. I've been doing them all, and I've just gone, you know what? No, it's not making me a better person. I'm ending that. Like, I've got a family. I've got principles. I've got responsibilities. Okay. And definitely the last 3 years, I've been trying to connect with what I would now.
And this is before you became a Muslim, yeah?
Yeah, well,
exactly.
Well,
because you changed your life.
Yeah. Because you see everything that Islam has made prohibited, like you mentioned, gambling, drinking,
family,
all these things.
You know how big becoming a vegan was.
The name, regarding the name.
You know how big it is not to drink.
If you also, you had a lot of negative
what? If you... The name Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you open any Arabic Bible, you will read in Genesis 1:31, 31 times Allah is the God of everyone.
Yeah, that's why I'm wondering why is it a big deal? Like, it has to be an Arabic word.
No, it's not Arabic word.
Before, no, I mean, you could have said to me, because it's
the name Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unique for the Creator and no one else have it. And no one else are allowed to have it. It's His Majesty, one of His most glorious name. And this is what He called Himself. When we say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allah, that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how He's the Creator of all.
I think I'm quite know where it's coming from. You're saying basically, what's the difference?
It's an Arab thing, you're saying.
And the rest of the world.
There wasn't Arabic at all. If the Prophet Muhammad was Persian.
Okay. Are you saying what is the difference?
No, he said if.
Baba, can we just stick to this point so we can progress, yeah? Are you saying what is the difference? Allah, God, everybody believes in God. Is that what you're saying?
No. Yeah, he's saying Allah is only unique
good.
To him. But he would have been.
Let me tell you this.
We wouldn't be having this conversation.
Okay, brother, if
that man named Al Arab.
Brother, do you mind?
The language of Arabic.
Brother,
the Persian.
Do you mind if you. Because the thing is, I'm trying to get somewhere. Because if. I'm trying to understand your core fundamental problem. Are you saying that Christians believe in God, Muslims believe in God, Jews believe in God, Hindus believe in God? What's the problem? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, that should be a problem.
Okay, good. So let me tell you what the fundamental problem is here. The main fundamental difference between Islam, which we discussed with Michael as well, which wasn't recording, is this. The concept of God in Islam is totally different to all the concepts with all the religions. Let me tell you why. We confirm Allah's rububiyyah. Allah is the Lord. We're singing out Allah in His Lordship. So we don't say, when Allah created the heavens and the earth, He needed Jesus there to help Him. We don't say that. We say Allah is the one who's the ultimate power. He's the one who created the heavens and the earth. Now, even the pagan Arabs believe this. Pagan Arabs, before Islam came, they said, we believe in Allah. We know He created us. No problem. We are just using these statues to get closer to Him. Now, they committed shirk in His uluhiyyah, meaning that Christians, what do Christians do? We believe in the Father, we believe in the one ultimate God. We get to Him through Jesus. Hindus say, look, we believe in God, the ultimate power, yes. We get to Him through Ganesh. What do the other religions say, the pagan Arabs? We believe in God, we go through it through Al-Uzza, Al-Lat. So now Islam came to say, hold on a second, this is not the pure way of monotheism. Because if you go to a Christian, you say, I'm a monotheist. Yeah, I'm a monotheist. Don't know, we say we're a monotheist, so what's the difference? The difference is the following, please listen carefully, brother. They worship via other things.
Deities, yeah.
Islam says you worship Allah alone.
Direct.
Now, another issue, this is, we single out God in His Lordship. He's the one who created heavens and earth. We single Him out in worship. So when we worship, we don't say, hey, let me go for Prophet Muhammad, ask him to go and ask. No. We go directly to God. The other third thing that was fell into shirk is His asma wa sifat, His names and His attributes. So when you go to the Christians, you say, God exists? Yes. Is He all powerful? Yes. God died on the cross? Yes. Whoa, hold on a second. Didn't we just agree God is the most powerful? How does the most powerful being get killed by a bunch of
Romans.
Jewish people?
Yeah.
Do you believe God is the most powerful?
Yes.
What if someone came and said, we killed God, just 10 minutes ago we killed Him?
Won't be God.
Thank you. So this is what makes Islam and the term Allah
unique.
Yeah. Because other gods, all other religions say the same, we believe in God. But all of them have some kind of a problem. Like with the Jews, we're very close. But what do they say, for example, even though one of them clarified today, that God rested on the sixth day, or God had a wrestling match?
7 days.
On the seventh day. Yeah. So we say, it doesn't befit God to have a wrestling match. It doesn't befit God to be tired, to sleep. Because we say in Surah Ayatul Kursi, yeah, we say that He does not get tired. So this is what makes Islam unique. And that is why Islam came.
Does the Bible confirm
that? Does that make sense?
Well? and Isaiah.
Yeah, one second. Yeah.
That guy over there is Jewish, and I think you'd say the same thing.
We're very close.
He just had a conversation.
I had a conversation with him. We're very close, yeah. But there's some things that they believe, which so we say.
I think what Ali is trying to say is that concept of God is different for different faiths.
Do you understand now what's unique about Islam?
Definitely. What could you possibly have argued with that Jewish boy then?
What we will argue is the following.
God regretted.
We can say, you know what?
They say in Genesis 6:6 that God regretted creating humankind.
See, we say God
can't. That one thing that was.
No, that's one. I can show you many if you want.
You're smoking.
But you see, like Brother Michael said here, everybody has their own journey. I think you have certain contentions, but I don't think they are quite significant because we might be talking cross purposes. You're saying the name Allah is Arabic name. The term is Arabic. Yes, it is. But what we are focused on is the concept of God. Yeah. How do other religions see God as? How do the Muslims see God as? How do the Jews see God as? How do the Christians see God as? So they all say they believe in God. They all say they believe in one God. But the way they describe God, the way they, the concept of God is different in this different. Otherwise, it wouldn't be different faiths.
It's flawed. So you said, for example, what's the big deal? Just because they say God regretted. We say that is a big flaw to God. So to say,
it's blasphemous.
I mean, if it wasn't in there.
Sorry?
If that regression wasn't in there, perhaps.
Okay, no problem. Let's suppose we and the Jews will believe in the same concept of God. Now what it comes down to is God is saying Islam is the final message. And this Quran is from me. And they come and say we reject it. You're rejecting the Kalam, the speech of God. Because Allah is saying Islam is the final religion. And the Prophet Muhammad is the final messenger. The Jews come and say, no. We don't believe in a prophet as a Gentile.
Also, the Jews are two messengers away.
Yes.
Yes, for example, they reject Jesus Christ as the Messiah. Openly, they also, the Christians reject Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam openly, and the Jews as well. So the Muslims, we accept all the messengers, all the prophets of God, the true messengers and prophets of God. Yes, so Prophet Muhammad, Jesus, Isa alayhi salam, Prophet Moses, Abraham, we say they all are, they all have the same status in terms of, we do not differentiate between the prophets. Yes?
May I say something? Islam, it didn't start with the Prophet Muhammad.
Yeah.
All the prophet and messenger, they submit to the will of God, which Jesus, peace upon him, teach. To surrender to the will of my Father. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the only worthy of worship, and all the religion like Judaism is not coming from Allah as a name. Christianity is not coming from Allah, but only Islam coming from Allah. Islam means to submit and surrender to the will of God, and this is the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala since he creates the creation. And there's no doubt about it, because we can see the many different man-made religion, and how people, as he explained to you, they are trying indirect way to come. Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, "Ad'uni astajib lakum," call me and I will respond. Whenever Allah, you sit and you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to you as long as you are sincere and honest. And this man, he have big heart and sincerity. This is what bring him to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show the love to him as he now is like a new person. And this is, we wish that you reflect upon what we are saying, because this is for your own journey toward Allah. Yeah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the hadith, if you make one step to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make two steps toward you. If you come in to him walking, he will come into you running. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love his creation and want him to just surrender and accept him. And in Christianity and Ezekiel teach that come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a new spirit, a new heart, and he will accept you, and he will give you paradise to be with him.
Because I need to go. Is there any questions? Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay, what's stopping you from defining yourself or calling yourself a Muslim? What's stopping you?
Because the politics, isn't it?
politics. We discuss the religion, man.
Allah's not going to ask you about politics. When you die, Allah's not going to say, hey, which politics, who did you vote for?
Yeah, wait.
Allah's not going to talk to you about it. What's stopping you from calling yourself a Muslim?
Let's do it. I think we should just go in and win.
That you need to be questioning yourself, because if nothing is stopping you, what?
Does he know what does it mean to be Muslim? Do you know what being Muslim?
He knows something.
What do you mean?
His parents.
To surrender to the way of God.
So what's stopping you?
Are you ready to take the Shahada?
No, but he's a Muslim.
Maybe he needs to renew it.
No, you're a Muslim. You just don't want to accept. You don't want to define yourself as a Muslim. That's what we're trying to understand. Yeah. But we've told you why.
Do you accept Muhammad as the messenger of God?
I was wondering. Why is it that it has to stop with...
The prophethood?
Yeah. Why does it have to stop? Why does it have to end?
Because Allah says so.
Where?
In the Quran.
How do you know that?
Because Allah says Khatimun Nabi, which means... Brother, one second. In the Quran, Allah has already made it very clear that he's Khatimun Nabi. Yes, it means he's a seal of the prophets. The seal of the prophets, it means, you know, when you seal something, when you want to close an envelope with a seal, that means it's closed. That's it. So it's up to Allah to decide who is the prophet and messenger. Nobody.
Possibly nothing.
Nothing. No.
Seekers and Baha'i.
Nothing.
In fact, Allah says the only religion which will be acceptable is Al-Islam. In the Quran. And he says to the Prophet Al-Yawma akmamtu lakum dinukum, which means today we have perfected your religion.
The philosophies within the world of Islam.
What's philosophies got to do with?
Philosophies of the scholars of the...
No, of course there are scholars. No, there are scholars.
That's different schools of thought. Maliki, Shafi...
But they are not prophets.
Shia...
No, that's a whole different discussion.
Yeah.
Is it really?
Well, of course, it's a whole different discussion.
It is.
Right now, do you accept being called a Muslim? Do you define yourself as a Muslim?
Even the Shias believe in Allah and Muhammad as a messenger.
Yeah. Do you call yourself a Muslim?
So do you accept... This is a creed, you see? This is the central creed of Islam. Whether you're Shia, Sunni, doesn't matter which sect you belong to. Yes, they all declare this.
So do you accept it as a Muslim?
No, I probably accept.
Okay, thank you. Okay. That's it. You don't need to accept. I don't need to take Shahada. You're already Muslim.
If you want.
Just what's in identify is it?
Sorry to interrupt.
Let them confirm it.
Thank you very much. If you have any more questions, I'll find it as well.
Thank you.
That's what makes Islam unique. The God, don't forget that.
Let him confirm it so we can be witness to Islam.
No, but he is a...
What's the difference between him and me?
Look, there's no difference. You already have it. You just said, okay, why should I call myself a Muslim? I personally believe you don't...
Yeah, I think he's a Muslim.
Did you have disbelief? Did you say, you know what, I disbelieve in Allah?
No, that's to say, I don't believe in God.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
No,
I don't.
No, you never said
that.
Did you ever say, I don't believe in the messenger?
One second. Let this conversation finish and then you can.
I want to, but wallahi, it goes somewhere else. Did you ever deny the messenger of Allah? Did you ever say, no, I don't believe in Muhammad?
No, I believe in them.
Yeah, come on, you're a Muslim. Because that is a core. Everything else is like secondary. You see what I mean? So everything else is secondary, but you need to believe in the core message. I think you had a problem with the term Allah because it's Arabic, and you might not be an Arab, so you might have a contention with it. But you see, the term Allah... Wait a minute, brother. The term Allah is the only one befits His Majesty. So take the term God. The term God has plural, gods. It has a feminine, goddess. Yes? Same with other languages. They have these terms which do not befit His Majesty. The term Allah is only reserved for the one true God. Nobody else. But the term God can be used for, say for example, an idol, you know, like a football. They say God of this football or God of this particular music concert. Yes? They can declare other people. This term is used for other people other than Almighty God. But in the case, you see how beautiful the term Allah is? It is only reserved for the one true Almighty God. Nobody else can use this term. In fact, even before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there were Arab Jews and Arab Christians who used to use the term Allah for the Almighty God.
All right. He said the Prophet is Persian.
Okay. Anyway, I think we should complete with this. Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.